chains that bind me. I need no shackles to remind me. I'm just a prisoner of love. For one command I stand and wait now. For one who's master of my fate now. I can't escape, for it's too late now. I'm just a prisoner of love. What's the good of my caring if someone is sharing those arms with me? Although she has another, I can have another, for I'm not free. She's in my dreams, awake or sleep. Upon my knees to her I'm creeping. My very life is in her keeping. I'm just a prisoner of love. What's the good of my caring if someone is sharing those arms?
cars we get around.
Talking about my generation.
Things ain't doing an awful.
Talking about my generation.
I hope I die before I get old.
Talking about my generation.
I dig what we all say.
I'm
not trying to cause a big sensation. I'm just talking about my generation. What we all
talking about my generation.
I'm trying to cause a big sensation. Just talking about my generation. Cause we get around.
Talking about my generation.
Things ain't doing it awful cold.
Talking about my generation.
I hope I die before I get old.
Hey, hey.
How's it going?
I'm good.
Anything I can help you with?
Yeah, actually, I'm kind of lost, and I don't know where I am.
I thought you looked kind of unfamiliar. Welcome to the town.
Yeah, I don't really have any service. I have a friend that was supposed to be telling me where to go, but...
Yeah, the service around here is kind of hit or miss.
Do you have any free Wi-Fi by chance?
Yeah, sorry. Like I said, that kind of stuff is hit or miss.
Do you have a phone I could use?
Well, the lines are down right now. We had a storm a couple nights ago.
A storm, really? This place looks untouched.
Yeah, I guess it cleared up pretty fast.
Could you at least tell me where I am? I'm supposed to be on Highway 6.
You really are lost, aren't you? Well, you're a long way from the highway, but I can point you in the right direction.
Shit! Everything okay over there?
I wish I could say yes.
Let me see here. You don't mind, do you?
No, not at all. I have no idea what I'm looking at anyways.
You see anything?
Well, nothing extremely noticeable from just a brief look, but the smoke doesn't help either. My guess is maybe faulty wiring casings or some overheated residue on the engine block, or maybe overheated liquids. Maybe something wrong with the cooling system here. Could be a simple fix, or could be something a lot bigger. That's probably a good idea maybe to call a mechanic.
If only I could call a damn mechanic.
No service? I can call a mechanic for you. You're just passing through?
Yeah, I'm trying to. Goddamn, even if I could find a mechanic guy, I sure as hell don't have the money for him.
Well, what are the odds that your car breaks down right in front of my house?
You're a mechanic?
For just about 38 years now. I can't tell you how many cars I've worked on. Lots of clients.
I mean, I could pay you with whatever cash I got.
You poor bastard. Keep it. Let me work on the car. It's been a while, and I am a bit rusty, but it might take me some time to get it back in driving shape, depending on what I find once I get in there. You don't have a place to stay around here, do you?
No, and to be honest with you, I don't even know where here is.
Oh, right. Well, look, I have a spare room in the house, and you're welcome to it. You help me push this thing over next to my shed, and I'll show you to it. How's that sound?
Sounds good to me.
Dedicate this song to little Junior Park. A cousin of mine is going on, but he'd like to kind of carry on in his name by saying,
is that everything?
This is it.
Alright then. My name's Malum, by the way.
My name's Elijah.
Okay, well, follow me and I'll show you that room.
Alright. Thank you.
Hey, are you hungry? I've already eaten myself, but I can fix you something to eat if you need it.
I'm okay. Thank you, though.
All right. How about a drink?
Sure. Couldn't see why not.
All right. I'll meet you at the table.
Cheers.
So, you got a long way ahead of you? Where are you off to?
Well, I've got about an hour left of driving until I get to my friend's new place. I left just outside of Toronto, and I have to travel to about London, Ontario area.
Yeah, I tell you, it's a good thing your car broke down here and not somewhere down a deserted highway. So, I don't know how your car made it this far.
I honestly don't think the car looked that bad.
Well, not the outside, sure, but on the inside, oh, from what I've seen, I mean, how the hell did you get down here?
Yeah, I know, I could only access the directions for a little while. Thought I knew where I was going, but I guess my data went out and kind of just lost track of the directions.
Elijah, you were about a full 90 degrees in the wrong direction, my friend.
Yeah, I know, I was about to get back on that damn highway, but you know how that shit show goes. So, Malum, how long do you think it's going to take to get that car back in good shape?
Well, you know, I don't have a full diagnosis or anything here, but it could be a couple of days. Well, I'm not quite as efficient as I once was, but if you're fine staying for a couple of nights...
I don't really have any other choice. 30 years, was it? That, it was 30 years that you were a mechanic?
Well, it's 38, but 43 if you count my apprentice years.
Jesus, you were a mechanic for 43 years? No other job? You were just a mechanic?
Nothing else, yep.
Any hobbies?
No, not really. I tried my best when I wasn't working to spend time with my family.
You got a wife or any kids?
Yeah, both had a wife and a boy.
Whereabouts are they now, if you don't mind me asking?
Oh, geez, I became a widower, I think, I was 37, you know. Can't quite remember, my memories are all kind of bundled together here. Haven't had too many people to help me reflect on this, you know.
Of course, yeah, you don't have to answer any of my questions either if you don't want. Just trying to make some small talk.
Oh, nonsense. You know, it's probably best for me to get this stuff out in the opening. Yeah, my son left not long after my wife died. He was maybe 18 or 19 or so.
Have you talked to him since?
No, we were never close. So there was really nothing to revisit. Last I heard, he was doing quite well. Would you care for a refill?
Only if you're having.
I'm having for sure.
Thank you.
Policing. He wanted to pursue policing. When he was a boy, there were missing persons cases all over the papers. After a month or two, they'd find a body. Women, young women, and sometimes a bunch of young men as well. It would just sicken our household, hearing and reading about all these atrocities. He, my son, would always tell his mama that he would be the one to catch these monsters, as we raised them right, I guess.
Yeah, it's an excellent line of work.
Yeah, sure is. Say, what do you do? You must be about the same age as my son when he left, 18 or 19?
20, actually.
So, what's your work?
I don't know what to say. Nothing to be too proud of, though.
Well, what do you mean?
Well, I've done all kinds of jobs, actually. I've been retail, grocery, fast food. I've done some odd jobs out there as well, just to get some extra cash. But honestly, I can never really care for those normal, regular kind of jobs, nor could I keep them. It just felt draining and soul-crushing, and honestly, I just felt like I could do something that I'm more passionate about, something that I could actually enjoy.
So what is it then? What's the passion? What's the dream?
Well, you're probably going to laugh or call me some naive millennial.
Oh, shoot. The devil's juices are flowing now. So what do you do? What do you want to do?
Well, I always wanted to go into the performing arts, you know, acting and such.
Acting? Oh, big movie star, eh? Have you been in anything yet? Movies or plays?
Well, as far as plays go, I haven't gotten a real role since I played Hamlet in my high school senior year. Besides that, I've gotten a few extra parts, just things I've been called up for, but nothing too grand. And in more recent terms, it's just been hard for me to stay motivated.
Well, how is it hard? What's stopping you from going after what you want?
I wanted to go to school for it, but most programs I applied for, I ended up getting rejected, and the ones I did get accepted for weren't really in my price range, so I never really ended up going. And most will just tell you that education and acting is just unnecessary, and all you'll need is good experience and lots of it. And I don't even have that aside from some high school plays or some shitty student films. And I tried to do, well, I'm trying to do the other way, the other side. You know, going for auditions and rehearsals, you know, really trying to do it on my own. I would try to rehearse lines with my buddy Deacon and start to get hyped up and a little bit too optimistic, and just ended off with no calls back, though. I get the background part, so at least the back of my head is in a shot for a split second. So I guess in the end of the day, my hard work's really paying off, or I'm just fucking full of myself. And maybe I was only half-decent actor from my high school, and come to think about it, that's what helped with my self-delusion. I haven't landed a good part in about 2 years. There's my lack of motivation.
Well, don't give up. You know, as bad as it seems, the pendulum does swing both ways. You almost need awareness when you're at your highest and when it's a good time to lay low for a while. If you're not prepared to land on your ass once in a while, it will hit you harder.
You think this is just temporary?
It always is. The storm always passes.
It's been about 2 years of this shit, and it feels like longer. I appreciate your confidence, but I've had those thoughts again and again that it's just a temporary period or a phase. And I really question sometimes if I still should be following this. I feel like this unending feeling of defeat is just a sign from the higher power to try and get me to find something else.
I don't want to offend you or seem like I'm discrediting your current standing, but I think you just got to stick it out. I think what you just said to me is a bunch of shit. If you were truly passionate about acting, you should pursue it with predatory instinct. That's what I've done, and success has been near imminent.
I had my life to live over again. I would truly take you for my love again. Oh, how I'd love you. Of mine that I have for you.
Not much of an early bird, are you? Want a cup of coffee?
Yes, please. Thank you.
Cream and sugar?
2 teaspoons of both, please.
Okay. Here we go.
Thank you.
You're welcome. So did you manage to get a good sleep last night?
When I was able to actually fall asleep, I sure was.
Yeah, you didn't happen to be outside last night, did you?
No, I had an early night last night. Did you see someone outside?
Nah, I just kept up by some noises, that's all.
Noises?
I don't even know, it was just the odd sound, really. It was probably just a collage of night critters. But I could have sworn I heard footsteps. And cautious ones, too. As if whatever, or whoever was out there, didn't want to be heard. Creeping.
Might have been a fox or even a coyote. They tend to linger around here this time of year. They'll creep around a little bit too.
Yeah, despite the sounds, it was just eerily quiet. And that damn window panel came loose, and the silent winds, they just kept picking it up, slamming it from the outside wall to the window socket, back and forth, over and over again.
I tell you what, before I start the car, I'll go and fasten that panel to the side of the house.
You really didn't hear that thing? Anything?
No, it was an early night. I'm a heavy sleeper, or maybe I'm just used to it.
Lots of talent. Jesus.
Well, when you come to an age where more of your life is behind you than in front of you, too often sleep is the only escape. I still get to dream. You seem to be almost afraid of the night. Are you afraid?
Am I afraid of the night? The dark?
Yes, you seem afraid. You're letting every little sound come out of the shadows, allowing it to bring terror. You could hear the same thing in the daytime and probably wouldn't bother you. You wouldn't complain. So, are you afraid of the night?
Sure, I'm afraid of the night. When I hear something during the day, I can look around and attribute it to a certain cause, but during the night I can only assume. But that doesn't scare me. It's just not as reassuring. And you're telling me that you're not even a little bit uncomfortable when the sky and everything underneath it is engulfed in darkness?
Beautiful things happen in the nightfall, in the dark. And when the sun goes to sleep, the stars come out and prove your insignificance. The world is beautiful, even in the dark. So, any plans on what you might do today?
Am I not going to be helping with the car? I'm willing to give a helping hand.
Probably best if I did it on my own. You know, I get in my own rhythm. You probably just get in the way, especially if you don't know what you're doing.
Oh, okay. Well, if you're fine to do it alone, I guess it's okay with me. I'll just stay back and write.
What are you writing, a novel?
No, a play, actually. I've been trying to find some time to write the plot out and develop characters, but I haven't really gotten to it. I guess this car breaking down is a blessing in disguise after all.
Ah, well, there you go.
Might check out the lake later, too. Is the water any nice down there?
Oh, it varies day to day, but sometimes if it's windy, it washes all the seaweed up on the shore. Nevertheless, since the storm, we've had some pretty calm weather, so it should be pretty nice down there.
Well, that's good.
Just be careful around the high ledges.
Ledges?
Oh, it's a cement retaining wall lining the lake. It's just about 10 feet tall or thereabouts. I only say to be cautious because on certain rare occasions, careless individuals have been walking along the ridge and they trip and they fall off the cliff.
Did those individuals
die? Yes, but it's been a more of an infrequent occurrence. When I was a boy, a friend of mine was presumably walking or playing along the edge of the wall. He must have slipped or tripped. He was found with his skull caved in on the rocky shore of the lake.
Well, how old were you when that happened? That must have been scarring.
I was about 15 years old. It's undoubtedly a vivid memory. Well, I thought I'd just warn you. I wouldn't want you to end up like my old buddy.
Sadists, yeah, I remember that look in his eye. It was a night of the sadists, yeah, I remember.
You got a pen?
What? I can't hear you.
No, a pen. You know, mine just out of ink. I was wondering if you had an extra.
There's a white cabinet in the living room. Look in one of the top drawers.
I kissed you and called you sweetheart. Do the chairs in your parlor seem empty and bare? Do you gaze at your doorstep and picture me there? Is your heart filled with pain? Shall I come back again? Tell me, dear, are you lonesome
Yeah.
fortune. How empty they can be. But when I hold you in my arms, that's a heaven to me. Who cares for fame and fortune? They're only passing things. But the touch of your lips on mine makes me feel like a king. Your kind of love is a treasure I hold. It's so much greater than silver or gold. I know that I have nothing. If you should go away, but to know that love he brings fame and fortune my way. But to know that love he brings fame and fortune my way.
I'm fine. It's just a little trip.
That was my fault. I should have moved that damn shovel.
don't worry about it. I should have just had a better eye on where I was going.
No, I'm so sorry. No, I feel horrible. That was all my fault.
Oh, it's okay. It's okay.
You're dead. Oh my gosh, your head. You're bleeding. You've got a really good scrape there. Maybe we should get you some ice.
Oh no, it's okay. My house is just a couple houses down. I'll get some ice there.
Okay, of course. Okay, we'll have a good one.
Yeah, thank you. You as well.
Take the high.
Can't sleep?
No.
Figures. How could you sleep on a night like tonight?
Well, it sure is a nice night for a fire.
Well, tomorrow's supposed to be better. But I suppose by that late hour you'll be on your way.
Yeah.
So what are you drinking?
I don't know. Whatever you're having, I guess.
You sure? That's quite strong.
Oh, why not? Just a bit, though. Oh, geez, that's some strong stuff.
I tried to warn you. Well, I'm gonna have another one. You are quite welcome to join me. But I'm going to need much more than one more glass of this devil juice to see me through after working on that car all day.
Think the car is going to be all good by tomorrow?
Yes, it'll be just a few things to finish up. Probably be ready sometime tomorrow afternoon.
Well, if this is the last day I'm going to be here, I'm going to have to join you in another drink.
That's the spirit. Drink up.
Cheers.
You know what, Elijah?
What's that, Malum?
You know, you're right. You never know what creepy, petrifying things come around lurking in the dark once the sun descends and the night comes in.
Nice to see you again.
You as well. This might be the last I see of me around here.
Oh, why is that?
Well, the only reason I'm actually here is because my car is broken down and left me stranded here, but I should be good to go by tonight.
Why would you want to leave a place like this?
Well, my friend is waiting for me to move in at his new place, but it's already been about a 3-day delay, and with the reception, I haven't really been able to reach out to him. I just know he's worried sick.
But why would you want to leave a place like this?
Just this town, it doesn't feel normal. It feels like, kind of like a ghost town. It's just strange and abnormal.
You know, you look better, but I think you may have a concussion. I don't think the little band-aid and ice are enough. You may need to be seen by a doctor. You need help.
What?
Well, I better get going. Those plants and flowers of mine aren't going to water themselves. I was just taking a small break. Do you have any plans before you depart?
I might go for a swim.
Oh, delightful. It really is a nice day. A good swim on a summer's day is refreshing for the soul. Well, I better get going. I can get some good work in before sunset. Farewell.
Yeah.
Fuck. Ooh.
Like an angel, walk like an angel, talk like an angel, but I got wise. You're the devil in disguise. Oh, yes, you are.
Zolpidem. I've been putting it in your meals and coffee, injecting you while you sleep. Copious amounts. It's typically for those suffering with insomnia, but assuming that you don't, you would only endure the severe effects like hallucinations and all that jazz. I've poisoned you, but you won't die from the poison. You know, I used to kill faster than this. I did it for pleasure. There was satisfaction. I had passion. It was really fun. It still is a little fun. But you are not going to die for a burning passion and pleasure within me. No, but because it needs to feast. It must feast.
I'm not going to be able to do that. Thank you.